and welcome to another segment of DSU Inside Perspective. I'm Carlos Holmes, and this is the show where we talk with faculty, staff, students, researchers, administrators, and even guests from the outside about some of the things that are going on in the world and some of the great things that are going on at the Delaware State University. Today, I have Dr. Jacqueline Washington, who is the Associate Dean of our College of Health and Behavioral Sciences. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
I had you have you on the show today because I wanted to talk with you about our students and the help that they appear to be getting right now to go to medical school. Now, to go to medical school, that's more than a notion.
Indeed it is.
What are some of the challenges when it comes to going to medical school?
Well, first of all, I believe that many of the challenges stem from lack of exposure, lack of mentorship from the grade school level. Mm-hmm. Many students, particularly students of color or low economic communities, are not necessarily exposed to physicians or health professionals that may look like them. And so I believe that's where the challenge stems from. And then on top of that, I think that there's not a lot of preparation in the K-12 system to prepare students to really get academically adept to the journey of an application process for medical school. Typically, the application process is about 2 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So now you start with your undergraduate years and you major in whatever, biological sciences, chemistry, one of the sciences or something like that. And then a student applies to medical school. Now I hear Delaware State University has undertaken some measures to help our students in their pathway to medical school. Explain that.
Well, indeed we have. Actually, this is March 2019, February of 2018, so just 13 months mm-hmm. In the game. Actually, there's been a committee that's established called the Health Professions Committee. Mm-hmm. And since last year, we've developed this committee into a extended program, which is like an infrastructure of support to help students navigate the process for applying to medical school. Yeah. But there is one thing I want to say before I go further into that. Yeah. You do not have to be a STEM major or a major in the traditional sciences to go to medical school. In fact, many medical schools find it very attractive for students to come from social sciences, humanities, or those non-STEM majors because they are more the well-rounded students and actually better connected mm-hmm. to the field.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have this health professions committee?
Yes.
Okay. What does this committee do?
So we provide pre-health or pre-medical advising to students who have expressed their interest, mm-hmm. as well as we help them navigate the application process, which requires quite a bit. It requires some programming, some seminars and workshops so that students understand what courses they need to take, also what are the different components of the application process, mm-hmm. the interviews, getting experiences off campus that require shadowing or mm-hmm. clinical experiences. Mm-hmm. So as you can imagine, as I'm talking about these various components, it takes a lot of time, particularly mm-hmm. for a student who's working and trying to go to school full time.
Mm-hmm. So prior to the establishment of the Health Professions Committee, the students were basically pretty much on their own.
Well, somewhat. I mean, it's my understanding that there have been some students receiving help on an individual basis, but I do not believe that the help was on the scale in which it is today.
This seems like a more concerted effort to help any student that we have, not only help students that we have that have aspirations for medical school or dental school, mm-hmm. but also help folks understand what the possibilities are in those areas, so they might decide to want to go there.
Yes.
Now, I understand that there's also, in addition to the Health Professions Committee, a student organization that has been given birth mm-hmm. as a result of these efforts. What is that?
So that organization is called MAPS, which stands for Minority Association for Pre-Medical and Pre-Health Students. Mm-hmm. And it's the undergraduate arm of the Student National Medical Association, okay. which began in 1964 or 65, I believe, mm-hmm. by medical school students who were attending Meharry and Howard University Medical Schools. Mm-hmm. And typically, this organization has been birthed, as you said, last semester, so that we can engage more students and so they can find a community and somewhere that they can connect to get encouraged about their process.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So students, this was established for the students. This kind of puts them in the environment where they're around peers that are trying to do the same thing.
Absolutely, absolutely. And also to connect them to resources as well as opportunities, mm-hmm. Particularly shadowing, connecting with physicians or physician assistants and research opportunities in the biomedical sciences. We have had now a tremendous effort working with Christiana Care Health System and also Bay Health and other organizations now who know about the Health Professions Committee program as well as MAPS. Everyone's excited.
Mm-hmm. So if a student sees this segment mm-hmm. and they're interested, what can they do?
So what they need to do is they need to reach out to me,
mm-hmm.
jawashington@desu.edu. And they need to express in their email to say that they are a student who's interested in pursuing medicine or dental medicine or something in the health professions. And then we can take it from there. Set up an appointment mm-hmm. and we'll take it from there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, well, it sounds very exciting and it sounds like a tremendous help for our students that have these aspirations. We want to see our students make their mark on the world.
Absolutely.
So this is a way to help them out. Thank you so much for coming on the show and sharing this information with us. If you're interested in getting some help, getting some assistance, getting some information about how you can get yourself in a better position to be enrolled in medical school or dental school, Dr. Washington is the person to talk to. Thank you so much for being on the show. And thank everybody for joining us for this segment of DSU Inside Perspective. Everybody have a good day.